Thursday.
Still in Barstow. Well, we kind of figured this.
We did.
It's been very quiet today. I think only a couple loads have come across. Still not in this area, and they don't even pick up till Monday.
Yeah.
Which that could be the case. There may not be anything until Monday.
I don't mind.
Yeah. It's been nice.
Yeah, I've made a few calls to the agents that we like to work for out here and made sure we're showing up on the truck search if they do a truck search for out here in California.
There are a few trucks out here in the area. What, you looked it up?
Yeah, there's like three trucks. There's another truck around here somewhere in the Barstow area.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's another one just down south near Victorville or Hesperia, probably at that pilot down there.
Oh, yeah. You know, we don't mind having the few days off. It's been nice. We've gotten a lot of stuff done.
Yeah.
I just finished doing December's paperwork, so our whole year is done now for our paperwork.
We actually did better.
Yeah.
2019 than we did in 2018.
Which is surprising because we were thinking we were going to do less gross-wise because of the, you know, the way trucking has been this year. It's been slower, but we still grossed more this year than we did last year.
Well, and it's funny too. We grossed more per year in 2018, but in 2019, I said that wrong. We grossed more in 2019 than we did 2018. But in 2018, our all miles rate per mile was higher than 2019.
Yeah.
So,
which means we ran more miles.
More miles, but for a little bit cheaper.
Yeah. That could be more deadhead.
More deadhead we've done.
You know, there could be a lot of factors in that.
We haven't really dove down into it like quite yet. But, you know, we could have had more expenses, maybe spent more fuel. A lot of things factor into it. And it's not a drastic amount. Gross total was like $6,000 more.
Yeah, something like that.
But then it was like 10 cents less per mile we ran from last year.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Not drastic, you know. We were up at like $1.98.
Yeah.
All miles, so not too bad.
I'm really going to be curious to see once we get that new truck how...
how it affects our freight.
Yeah, how it affects the loads we get. And, of course, you know, we'll share all of that with you once we get in and rolling in it. And
we're going to have an extra axle and more tires on the ground, so we'll be spending a little bit more fuel.
That's true.
Higher tolls.
Yeah, that's true,
higher IFTA taxes because we're getting less fuel mileage.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. So we'll see how it plays out.
It'll be interesting to see how it balances out. I think we've done amazing for a two-axle truck, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
We've done absolutely amazing with just a two-axle truck.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
We're happy with it. We'll see how the new truck does.
Mm-hmm.
Being able to carry more weight, will it really bring that many more loads to offset the added costs? You know?
I mean, I will tell you, us adding the liftgate, you know, we've had it now, almost 2 years. And I'm still happy that we added the liftgate and spent that money because we've gotten loads that we wouldn't have got not having it. It has not hindered us in any way.
No.
But I will say we don't do a lot of automotive freight. We really do no automotive freight. Now, if you do a lot of automotive freight, a liftgate might hurt you because... there's a lot of automotive plants that if you have a liftgate, they can't lock your truck in.
Yeah.
I know they make some that they still can lock it in. So if you do a lot of automotive and you're thinking about a liftgate, you might talk to whoever's doing your liftgate to find out, make sure they're going to still be able to lock onto your truck.
Yeah.
And
check with your company. If it doesn't make sense to get a liftgate, if your company doesn't do a lot of liftgate freight, there's no sense in getting one.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
You know, it's really subjective where you're at, what company you're with, what type of freight you're hauling, and all that.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, we've definitely, the loads we have gotten because of the liftgate has well paid for it already.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we're really happy. And the new truck's going to have a liftgate, too.
Yeah. We'll see how 2020 does.
Yeah.
You know, there's been a lot of companies going out of business, a lot of layoffs, a lot of that. But then I hear a lot of people saying 2020 is going to be great and lots of freight. And so, you know,
you never know.
We'll say, yeah, everybody's got their predictions. All we can really do is roll with the punches and try to be as prepared for it as possible.
Yeah. I mean, things change, you know, just like that AB5 law. They just put a halt on it, what, January 1st or December 31st?
December 31st, last day of the year.
Yeah, a lot of folks have asked us how that is going to affect us. It will. As far as we know, it's not right now because we don't live in California.
No.
As far as we know, it's only affecting the people living in California who has residence in California.
Yeah.
Now, that could change. Who knows?
It's funny. We get a lot of people asking us, what are your thoughts on the company going out of business? Or what are your thoughts on AB5? And honestly, it's just part of the business.
It is.
It really is. I try not to put too much emphasis or thought process into it. It sucks for a lot of people a lot
Absolutely.
Of times. And, you know, it's just one of those things that happens in trucking. And it's been happening since the dawn of trucking, you know.
Yeah.
Companies go out of business. Drivers lose their jobs. Drivers get laid off. We have a influx of drivers, and then we have a shortage of drivers. And, you know, all that plays into account of how you operate, what loads you accept, and what you run for. And, you know, all we can really do is manage our business.
Right. Yeah,
the best possible way we can.
Yeah,
that's all we can do, you know, because we have no control over the rest of it.
Yeah.
They're going to come out with new regulations. We're going to have recessions where all that stuff's going to happen, and it's going to keep happening. Will 2020 be great? Maybe. And maybe 2021 will be absolutely horrible or vice versa, you know. The only thing you have control of is your operation.
That's true. Now, that doesn't mean that we don't follow what's going on.
Yeah, we read it.
Research it and see how it may affect us, may not affect us, you know.
Yeah.
That's all part of business. You've got to keep up with that kind of stuff, obviously. But, yeah, the only control we have is what we do with our business and how we run it. And
we're constantly trying to figure out a better way to operate cheaper.
Yeah.
How can we reduce our operating costs and keep more in our pocket? That's the name of trucking.
And it's funny, too, because, you know, we share a lot of the stuff we do with you guys. That doesn't mean it's the right way. It doesn't mean it's the wrong way.
Nope.
It doesn't mean that'll work for you or not work for you.
Yep.
It is not that we know everything. We are just sharing our journey with you guys.
You have to make your own decisions and do your own research, see what's going to be best for you, and you either roll the dice and win or lose. You
sometimes
know?
We make great decisions, and sometimes we make horrible decisions.
Some people are like, y'all are idiots.
But it's our business.
It's our business.
That's if you're in trucking, it's your business, how you run it, you know.
And just because you do it one way doesn't mean it's going to work for us. Just
and vice versa,
We do it one way doesn't mean it works for you. Everybody's got their way of doing things, and you try to incorporate things you learn from others, and sometimes it works, sometimes it don't.
Yeah. And a lot of, like, for us, you know, being in the expedited side of trucking, it's a lot different than the traditional trucking. Even an owner-operator in a big tractor trailer for a big trucking company.
Yeah,
it's much different. Even in Landstar. Landstar tractor trailer drivers' business is run a lot differently than the Express division, which is what we're in.
Yeah. We're the same company, but it's completely different. Like,
completely
there's a lot
different.
Of different things that go on.
Yeah, they get a lot of loads off the load boards. We don't.
We look at it sometimes, but a lot of people, all they do is operate off the load board. And for us, we never touch the load board.
No.
So it's, you know, and it may work for others. Doesn't work for us. And I'm wobbling the camera here trying to hold it steady because we've been
sitting here. We're rambling about business.
It's just,
you know, these things get in our head and we ramble about it. But just sharing our thoughts and stuff with you guys.
Yeah.
But man, I don't know I made
it's January, February. It could be pretty slow next couple months. So we'll see. We'll see what happens.
But yeah, I made us some breakfast, and it's only like it's not even noon here yet.
No,
man, when we're out here on the West Coast, the time is time's all messed up. Like we're usually up early,
almost noon. It's 11:43. Yeah. Almost. It was funny. I got up at 4 o'clock yesterday and then stayed up till 2 o'clock this morning.
I know. We slept in a little bit this morning.
A little bit this morning, but yeah.
It still get up early because it's like we're used to like being on Central Time. And it's two hours difference here. And, or 2 hours. Yeah. I think about it sometimes. But okay. Well, let's keep rambling. Posted on what happens.
We'll see what happens. No love for the crafties.
Wah, wah. We kind of figured that though.
Yeah.
We really did. It's not a surprise.
No.
But we've had a nice relaxing day.
We have. It kind of boring, but relaxing.
Yeah.
We don't get that often.
Watch out for landmines.
Oh, crap.
We're walking through the dog area.
Well, we decided we were going to go have Black Bear Diner.
Yeah.
And keep it keto style.
I was just kind of tired, didn't feel like cooking. I cooked breakfast.
Yeah.
And I made us some guacamole earlier.
Yeah.
But it's a beautiful sunset here.
It is.
Wow. I love the sunsets here.
I love the like teal and orange colors of the skies. Just amazing.
So pretty.
All right.
We'll see if we hear something tomorrow.
Yep.
I don't know. It may be next week.
Maybe next week, right. Let's go get our grub on, woman. Getting going there.
Ooh, I am making some chaffle BLTs for brunch, I guess. I've already got one done, getting the other half of that one done, and I'm getting ready to make another set so we each will have one. I've already cooked our bacon. Ooh, bacon. Mm. You can't go wrong with bacon, right? I haven't made BLT chaffles yet, and I've been wanting to. So I finally picked me up a tomato the other day when we stopped at Walmart. Ugh, they're gonna be so good. I love chaffles, man.
Me too.
That's like our go-to now.
So no load yet?
No.
We're still hanging out here with a bunch of stuff coming across for next week.
I was gonna say, there has been more stuff coming across this morning on the QC, the Qualcomm.
Yeah, a bunch of stuff. So.
Jason called an agent that had a load out of Utah just to check and see what it was.
Yeah, but it was...
One picking up till Tuesday. She had two. One Tuesday, one Wednesday, but they were both coming back to California.
And they were cheap, so it wouldn't be worth the deadhead. So
no.
Those are times where we will not deadhead.
No. And she understood. Most agents understand.
Yeah.
You know?
It has to make sense all miles.
Yeah, absolutely. But I don't know.
As you guys know, we will deadhead some miles for a load if it makes sense.
If it makes sense and the all miles rate works out, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't be afraid to deadhead for sure.
Nope.
If it makes sense. But, man, this is smelling so good. I love when...
Hey.
Oh, he's not impressed.
Hey, lazy bum. You know, it's time to get up.
Hey, I have already gotten them up and let them out. They're just now taking their late morning nap again.
What do you think?
Abby, she's always up.
She's always up. If we're up, she's up.
Yeah.
What you scratching on? Hey, Missy.
She said, Mama got bacon.
Mama is cooking. I am awake.
I smell it. I want some.
I want it. This guy, he's like.
He's like, I don't care.
Let's see if we can rustle him up.
What you doing, buddy?
What you doing, little guy?
No.
Oh.
He says, I'm comfy, Daddy.
Oh, you comfy and warm?
Yeah. He's not in the... He's like, I don't play this early in the morning.
No, it's too early.
Early
it's too early.
It ain't even early. What time is it, golly?
little boy.
I guess the plan today, I plan on cleaning the truck. I've got our vacuum plugged up, charging up, and hold on, let me get my chuffle. That's my timer. I set a timer for 4 minutes because that's like perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect doneness that we like. There it is. Oh yeah. Look at that goodness. Oh my gosh.
It kind of sucks because yesterday and today we really can't go and do nothing.
Yeah, I know.
Because we're kind of babysitting the Qualcomm, waiting to see if anything comes over.
Yeah.
But you don't want to leave the truck because Loke could come across and somebody else could beat you to it, and
yeah, unfortunately,
then you're out the luck. But
yeah, unfortunately, not all the agents, before they put loads out, look at what trucks may be in that area and call. They just put it out.
They just put it out and let the dogs go at it.
Yeah.
Right. I'm on freight. That's
right.
My freight.
Yeah, exactly. So. But yeah, I'm just going to finish making this. We're going to have us a nice little brunch, and then I'll probably will start cleaning.
Cool.
Sound good?
Sound good. Is that all right with you, Missy?
She's like, I just want some food. I don't care what you do. I just want what Mama's cooking. Happy Saturday! Still in Barstow!
Still in Barstow.
Not a shocker, though.
No love for the crafties.
No loads at all this week. But yeah. We kind of figured that. I mean, we were hopeful we would get something.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's not a surprise that we didn't.
I think last year we sat in...
where were we last year for New Year's?
Tifton or...
Somewhere.
Somewhere south down the 75 towards the Florida border.
Yeah,
so
we'll have to go
there's
back.
There's a TA and something else over there.
Yeah.
Yeah. But.
We'll have to go back and look at the videos this time last year and see where we were.
Yeah.
I can't remember where we were yesterday or the day before half the time. So
yeah,
how am I going to remember a year ago?
Right.
Unless so there was something momentous that happened.
So we dropped off our last load 7 days or Monday. Last Monday. And we'll probably be here till this following Monday. So
yeah.
It's this sitting part that really gets to people sometimes. But
it
we enjoy it.
Yeah. And we've gotten to the point now where we do not mind, especially as much as we've been going.
Yes.
It's been nice to just have a few days to chill and not worry about anything.
Relax.
Get little things here and there done we needed to do.
Yeah, as you've seen, we detailed the truck yesterday.
Yeah, I love it. The whole inside of the truck's clean.
Everything's so spotless.
And yeah, and we just got back from, we went across the street to the Blue Beacon, so the outside's all nice and clean.
Yep.
We stopped at Flying J and dumped the pot and filled up the water.
No.
Oh, while we were over there, Jose, one of our viewers, saw us and came up and said hi.
Yeah.
It was so cool
meeting him. He had a really pretty...
beautiful German Shepherd.
German Shepherd, yeah.
Yeah. It was really cool. We always love when y'all come up and say hi to us. It's so nice getting to meet you guys in person, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, that was really nice.
Yeah, but what else did we do? Didn't we stop at Chipotle, got lunch there.
I got a salad. We're killing it on keto this week.
Yeah.
We are. We're gung-ho. Like, we're telling each other, no, you can't have that. You know, that's not keto. No. You know, we've gone out to dinner a couple times and...
Kept it keto.
We've been to...
Black Bear
twice.
Mm-hmm.
you know, kept it keto, no buns, but fries.
No, I'm still really good with my keto. I will say though, over the last few months, I've kind of slid off of it a little bit. I've been eating more carbs, let's say.
Yeah, yeah.
I still try to keep it keto. Like I don't eat bread and all that, but I'll have fries. And I told Jason at the first of the year, I need to get back on it a little stricter, and I really want him to get on it.
Yeah, no, it's no New Year's resolution.
No,
it's just something we've been trying to do, and you know, right now is the time we need to do it.
Yeah, we need to do it. It's just really been nice having the time just to chill, because yeah, who knows what's gonna happen. Hopefully the truck's gonna be ready really, really soon.
Really soon.
Like, and once that's ready, we're gonna have to get up to Ohio, and that's gonna be a lot of work.
That's gonna be a lot of work.
Getting stuff.
Moving over into it, and
yeah. But I'm excited for it. I'm ready for it. Yeah. I've been ready for it. I know y'all have been ready for it too.
I know. I never knew it'd take this long.
Yeah. I mean, it is what it is, you know. I think we've told you guys there's some special things we were having done to the box. So that kind of put it longer for them to do, which we'll talk all about once we get the truck
yeah,
of what they
yeah,
had
yeah.
to do. But that kind of pushed out the time frame too, even though it shouldn't have taken as long as it has, but with the holidays and everything, you
yeah,
know, it's understandable. And but it'll be very soon.
Very soon.
Very soon. Can't wait. I'm excited.
So we gonna end this one here or what?
Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and end this one here, guys. We will pick up the next one and see what happens, where we go from here. I don't know. We'll see.
Okay. We're going to spend the rest of the weekend just relaxing.
Yeah. Yep. So. Absolutely. You've got to do your relaxing time when you can.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you guys as always for watching and subscribing.
And until our next video.
Peace, love, and expediting.
Peace.
Peace.